Hello guys and welcome to a brand new video. So today we're gonna talk about Yesterday by the Beatles. You probably saw my performance at the beginning. I just wanted to show you what I had in front of me when I recorded it. So in front of me, believe me or not, I just had this little lead sheet. So it's called a lead sheet just because it has only one lead line. So only one line instead of two like the actual piano sheet are, right? So this one, it is a classical piano sheet, yes, it is a piano sheet. And then this one, it is an actual lead sheet. So in front of me, I had this one. You can download this one, which is the actual, what I actually played into the recording. So it is the actual transcription. And also this one, in the link in description, all for free. So let me just explain you how this thing works. So we got these letters, which are the actual chords on the top of it, right? So what you need for actually read or interpret it, lead sheet music, you need a very good chord knowledge. So just subscribe to my channel and look to or send me an email if you want me, like, or comment below if you want an actual lesson only about the chords and only how they work. And so you need a very good chord knowledge. You need to know how to read the simple sheet like that. So, like, you know that this one is G, that this one is F, and so on. Some phrasing knowledge. So in phrasing, you just need to know sort of scales. So the scales, they can vary between major and minor, as you probably know. The modal scales are also very good to know, so the Mixolydian, all the stuff like that, they are very good. Just comment below if you want me to do an actual lesson only about the modal scales, only about the chords, and only how to read the sheet music, but I think that you know it already. So, let's have a look straight away to the very beginning. So, you probably saw me play it like that, which I do stuff like. But this one, it is my actual interpretation. What is written here, you see that there is this F, this low note is an actual F, that you can play with your left hand, that one. And those ones are actually slash chords. So what those means? That means that you have to play this chord in this specific rhythm. So, what is actually written, it is this. But what is actually the good thing about a lead sheet is that you can reinterpret it. So you can give your own improvisation, your own, you know, your own comping. So, that's why, for me, I just chosen to do it like this one, which you actually sound like that. And so on and so on. Then, we got to the melody line, and you can see on the top we still have the chords. So what those means? You can play the chord together with the melody line. So, for example, this one, it is actually an answer to the melody. That means that I play the chord after this F. You can play also together with this F. So what I mean is, what I did here, I just play over this F, I played an F major chord. Right? So this one, it is actually targeting the melody line, like that. Then, what I do in the recording, you know, if I'm not wrong, I give this chord, which is a G over E, which is an actual E minor 7. So E minor 7 is a E, G, B, D, and that's the chord that is written in there, right? As we got this rest, we needed to give a space, but that doesn't mean that we don't have to play anything. That means that we can actually fill it with something. So In the actual sheet music, you can see that I'm playing a G chord, G major chord, which is a G, B, D. And in the left hand, I'm just playing a E. So together, they make a E minor 7 chord. Then, this one is actually very interesting, what have you, because here it says A7, but not everyone knows that when you got, in jazz actually, this one it is a jazz rule, when you have a 7, that means that you can add also your own extensions. What I mean by that? It is an actual A7, but I'm playing this chord, which is E, G, B, and C sharp, that together makes a A9 chord. So A7-9, but when I say A9, that means that the 7, it is inside. So you can see, in the actual sheet music, I play, this chord, right? So, what I mean, my point is that you can interpret it just by having your own knowledge. Of course, you need a very good knowledge of the chords, the 9 chords or the 13 chords, the extensions and stuff. Also the triad chords, the simple triad chords are very important to know, because you can apply this technique only using also triad chords. So let me give you an example. If I want to simplify that, the whole song is going to sound like that. So you can use only the triad chords. This one it is a triad of F major in a root position, a triad of F major in first inversion, and a triad of F major in a second inversion. You can use the simple triad chords as well to play the actual song by using only this sheet music. So you don't need to be good to read an actual sheet music like that to actually play one song. That's my whole point. So I hope that you found this useful. Please comment below if you need any explanation, any better explanation of the chords or of the scales they are using, and how to improvise better into an actual beat sheet. Yes, just comment below, and you can find in the description also, if you want some online lesson, you can find all the information in the description. You can send me an email. I can give you a free trial if you like. And again, I hope that you found this useful, and I'm gonna see you next time. Thank you very much for watching.